Question, you can see where we're going. So if anyone has a burning question that they've been dying to ask me for a week, a year, however your life, I'm here. And you may ask me questions, and so you may also ask Guy questions. Because he's so there's somebody with a roaming microphone and take your time. We'll feel our rhythm. Find our feet. Just like lovers do, me and you. Ooh, oh, love me like that. Ooh, oh, take me back to. It's the only place, it's the only place I want to be. Damn you, boy, you've no idea. Like that, see they've gone red. That means that they're now recording a loop. So in a bit, oh, see they've gone red. river. A body of water where people go to be happy, they go to be sad, they go to, you know, drop a dead body in it, they go to whatever they're doing, get married, you know, everything happens in that river, and it knows so many things. And I was in a boat above a building, the wrong way around. There was the water, there was the building, there was the boat. And I had a night to write a song, and I spent quite a lot of it walking along the bed of the River Thames, as all the, you know, the tide was far out. And I spoke to a man who told me that the time when he loves most on the river is when the tide is between in and out, and it's still. And I thought, wow, that's a beautiful thought, that even the river is always kind of moving, is at some point still. And I thought that the river is then kind of reaching out to you, going, be still with me, you know, just be still, breathe, be thankful, all that kind of thing. You know where to find me when you're on your way up. I'm bustle and busy, enough is enough. Cause life's sweet as energies are quick to drift world away. Be still with me. You know where to find me. Reason for stopping traffic behavior, or to get something off your chest. Cause we go a long way back to nothing at all. Be still with me.
First Train Home is
right here. Yes!
I just checked out the lyrics. What morning feels, paint the kitchen, love someone, I can't do anything. Good. Well done. Some people have got the wrong lyrics. Okay, cool.
I saw you in New Orleans 9 years ago.
Wow. Is this better or worse? Also, or you'd rather not say?
The world will be sad when you're gone.
Aww. I'm not going to go anywhere. I'm going to, like, freeze myself and stick around.
Good. Yeah! What has inspired you to become the music artist that you are? What led you to music?
Mm, Thank you. Thank you for your question. I'll find out where the other two are later. What has inspired me? In the beginning, it's just simply, well, the fact that my mum and dad really didn't listen to music, so I suppose I was like, could we just have some? Okay, I'll play it myself. But we also were very lucky, and we did have a piano in our house, and I was the middle child, so obviously I wanted as much attention as possible. And it was the loudest instrument in the house, the loudest thing in the house. So obviously that's where I went. I was like, I'm here, hello, pay some attention to me, middle child. But yeah, I suppose I don't know what inspires me. So many things, so many things. People's conversations, listening secretly to people's conversations on the tube. Okay. That's a funny one. I like that one. People like Guy, the amazing music that he makes. But it's also just, you know, whether inspiration happens to catch you at the right time, whether you're susceptible to being inspired. Because, you know, you might be in the most amazing place, but you might not be inspired because your mind's on other things. So I have learned that in order to kind of be ready for that, I need to kind of learn how to just, we didn't know it at the time. Yeah. And we really love this song. So here we go. I really like the four-part kazoo version of Hide and Seek. That's one of my favourites. I would say that was definitely one of my favourites for a long time. I really like Ariana Grande's version of the Guy from Girl. Yeah! Why? What do you like most? Maybe you've heard one I haven't heard. No. Okay, it's fine. This is good. This is why we check it. Oh, I know why. Okay. What's that noise? Oh, the microphone. Can somebody turn that microphone off in my ears? Because I can hear that. Okay, it's gone. No, it's still there. Still there. That. What is that? Is it gone now? Glove guitar.
Yes!
Okay, we're ready to rock, everybody. Feel free to cartwheel to the front of the stage or stage dive. Oh, no, I'm not going to stage dive because I'll just be up. Okay, here we go.
To have
Ableton or any kind of sequencing software like Logic or Cubase, then it's not hard at all because it's just mapping. It's just like you choose your glove, you choose the posture which you train, so you choose the postures, and then you just have like, you know, pitch, yaw and roll, so like a fader or a pot or a, you know, pitch bend. And then you've got postures combined with that, you've got directions, and then you've got what kind of feedback you want to have to kind of confirm you've done something, like, you know, the lights go on, or you can tell your buzzers to go if you've done something or not done something. So I wouldn't say it's hard. It's been incredibly hard, of course, for like 8 years. Well, for about 5 years it was really hard. But it's all, the secret is in this software called Glover, which is really amazing. That's actually the jewel of the crown. It's just so fantastic. I'm gonna see about if I was to do a bit of angry drum with the gloves. I don't know what key it's in.
E flat minor.
What?
E flat minor.
Stands my angry angel, and he's shaking his head in disgrace with me. Over there stands my angry angel, and he's shaking. speeding cars, the paper cuts, the cheating lovers, the coffee's never strong enough. I know you think it's more than just bad luck. Sleeping dogs lie never far enough away, glistening in the cold sweat of guilt. Life was just slowly winding down for years. You can't keep on like this. Now's about a time, as silly.
Does anybody know what the word stet means?
Yes.
They do? That's great. What does it mean?
It means when in a manuscript, when they say stet, leave it the same.
Yes. It's a way of saying it's not a mistake, don't correct it. It means let it stand. And so I thought, that's good. It's going to tell me not to correct it.
Yes.
Okay. Not that I'm a fussy producer. Does anybody know what the word stet means?
Yes.
Yes. Brilliant. Sent in one of my favourite sounds ever.
Thank you.
I'm the best. I could be the best decision you ever made. A beacon, your peaceful corner. Find me and cherish me. You choose. Wait, wait. Threaten me. I'm falling apart. Programmed one song. But we finally got it working today for the first time, so we thought, well, let's do one song. That's pretty good, because usually I'm... Right place at the right time. because in Washington DC, your country is going to be, or your people, whoever in the White House, are going to decide whether they want to take this to the next stage. And essentially what it is it's a small claims department that's going to be added into the copyright office, where essentially if, for example, can we talk about, is that okay or not? Yeah, so Zoe, amazing musician, who has this incredible music that lots and lots of dance companies, for example, as an example, love to use in their choreography. So they have, they go and tour the world, and they, a lot of these productions use Zoe's music, but they don't ask her. And maybe they don't know how to ask her, maybe they can't find her. But either way, they put her music in the play, and they tour, and they don't give her any money. And they earn money, and it's, you know, it's a lot of hard work to do what Zoe does, and it's really, really beautiful, and it adds so much, especially dance. There's not even any dialogue. I mean, come on. So, and they even have the cheek sometimes of saying it's Zoe Keating's music. So they know they're doing it, but they just don't give her any money. So what it does, the small claims, not just for musicians, but for photographers, for anyone, journalists, anyone who kind of writes IP or makes, you know, content, can then take, basically go to court or make, or kind of claim that, you know, this is theirs without having to have the upfront costs of a solicitor or a lawyer, and you can claim up to $30,000, I think. And it's really amazing. It's like, it makes a huge difference because it means that, you know, there's this law, hopefully there'll be this law in place, which means that they'll just go that little bit extra mile just to ask the permission from creators out there. So it's really great. It's a really great. It's water. Excuse me. Okay, here we go. Oh, it did that last time. Right, I'm going to save it now, and then it won't do that again. Let's go back to that place. Okay, here we go. Slightly awkward beginning to this song, okay. Inside out, I'm so twisting beside myself. Stop that now, 'cause you and I were never meant to meet. I think you better leave. It's not safe in here. I feel a weakness coming on. Oh, I'm still so. out the window in London, and it made me remember kind of being in the back of my dad's car, probably about to go to boarding school, going, oh God. Just seeing the snow and remembering drawing like faces in the back of his car, like on the condensation. And this song just kind of poured out. It was actually written over this guy called Ready Made, Funiculaire. You should go and check it out. You'll hear where it comes from. Because I like put on this track, and I was just listening to it, and then I just wrote the whole song over this little riff, which is the riff that we're going to play. You should check it out. It does actually credit him, and he said I could use it. He said, I can hear how it sounds like Funiculaire. That's really cool. I should call him up. Right, here we go. This is Headlock. Yeah! Which I'm not supposed to announce what it is, because it kind of has a fun way of starting it that you're meant to go, wait a minute, that sounds a bit like a slowed down headlock. Different bed, do something out of step. How do I? Oh, right, I'm meant to be here. If this is a question, is maybe a lie. If yes doesn't mean it, does when sometimes, but then it's your love. It's your love. Then it's your love. It's your love. But you've only got one. You've only got. The last record that I released was a music from the Harry Potter and the Curse of Child Clay. That's right. For some reason, they thought I would be a good match, which I think they were right, actually. But at first, I was a bit confused. I was like, really? What, me? You know I've never done a play before. You know, you do know that, don't you? This extremely, like, potentially very successful thing. You do know that I've never made any music for a play. Okay, just checking. But they did, they wanted me, thank you. And it was amazing, like sitting in a chair for about 3 months. I did get a really sore back, but I was sitting in the theatre while they were like bringing it to life. And, you know, I've never done that before. It was so amazing, like sound effects, lighting, you know, stage design, projection, mapping, actors, obviously. And it was just really amazing, and they're just, ah, oh, so cool. So they just somehow brought this out of me. But one of the songs that, there's a lot of original Heap music in there that's been like regurgitated and stretched and done all kinds of stuff to it. And if you're a Heap fan, but you don't want to listen to my lyrics and you like my music, but you're just like, oh, I don't want to listen to any lyrics, buy the album. There's no lyrics in it. Apart from one moment when they see Hogwarts for the first time, and then you hear my lyrics, but I wasn't allowed to sing it. So there we go. No, I was very happy that Anil, a friend of ours actually, who sings on Guy's record, sang. He had a choir, and so I asked him to sing this song because they do it very beautifully. And in the background of this song, I do lots of drones, and so I thought I'd kind of do a mashup of hide and seek, Harry Potter stuff. And so I'm just going to like talk about so a little bit. So I do the looping thing, and then at some point I kind of bring in some sounds. And also bring in some things like that. And then I'll just get those going for a bit. And then I'll take that down. And then if I want to bring in my harmonizer, I just do my one finger point. Ooh. And when I do that, I get my delay. And when I do that, I get my reverb. And when I do that, it goes backwards. I can be like, Imogen, Neshnami, Imogen. You didn't hear that because you were laughing. Let me try again. Neshnami, Imogen. I stole that joke off my friend Tim Exon, who's very much better at that than me, saying things backwards and then, anyway. And then, oh, then there's a thing called jellyfish, which is like this. Hello! Actually, that's not a big example. One, two, three, four. There, so I'm basically moving across a waveform. So I'll be like, la. Sold it out so quickly, so thank you for that. Okay, here we go.
Bye.
To share this new version with you, which we love. So, here we go. Are you ready? And this really is the last song with everyone on the stage. So, please give the guys an awesome round of applause. Say goodnight and go. taking everything off. Watch the curtains wide open. And if I have the same routine, picking through the TV, relaxed and reclining. And you think you're alone. Oh, I have to be so cute. It's impossible to. Say goodnight and go.